Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
All right, I've arrived. One of the recruits should be here in this area. Barely see. I'm afraid to take the horse in here. It might get swept up and drowned. See if we can't cross here. Here we go. Well, it's a good thing they were able to find a Dawn Guard uniform for me. I'd hate to be approaching these people as some unknown civilian.
What would mud crabs want with my satchel anyway?
Serene.
You haven't seen a sack full of dwarven gyros lying around, have you?
No.
I swear I left it right here. Do you think mud crabs might have taken it? I saw one the other day. Wouldn't be surprised if it followed me here.
Serene.
Look around, will you?
Serene, Isran asked me to find you.
Isran? Wants me? No, you must be mistaken. He made it exceedingly clear the last time we spoke that he had no interest in my help. I find it hard to believe he's changed his mind. He said some very hurtful things to me before I left. Anyway, I'm quite happy in my current pursuits. So if you'll excuse me...
Vampires threaten all of Skyrim. We need your help.
Vampires? Really? Oh, and I suppose now he remembers that I proposed no less than 3 different scenarios that involved vampires overrunning the population. Well, what are they up to?
Killing. And they have an Elder Scroll.
That's actually something I never would have anticipated. Interesting. I'm not sure what they would do with one, but in this case, Isran is probably correct in thinking it isn't good. All right. If nothing else, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to learn more about what's going on so I can better defend myself. But I'm not just going to abandon what I've been working on here. It's too useful. I need at least one intact dwarven gyro. So either I need to find the satchel those mud crabs stole, or I need another gyro from someplace. You wouldn't happen to have one, would you?
Usually I have almost anything, but there's no time. We need to get moving now.
Fine, fine. I can't afford to forget about this work, though. Some very interesting applications. Now... where is it I'm supposed to be going?
We're meeting at Fort Dawn Guard.
Ah, been working more on his secret hideout, has he? It'll be interesting to see how much progress he's made. I'll finish up here and head in that direction as soon as I can. See you there. Good day.
Yes, good day to you as well. All right, I had to use a little persuasion. Now, it's off to find the second recruit. What the hell? What's going on here? You! Gunmar!
There's a vicious bear on the loose.
Yes, I see it over the ridge.
You there! Hold fast! I've tracked this damned bear for 2 weeks. I'll not let it have any more victims.
Isran needs your help.
Isran needing someone else's help? Never thought I'd hear that. I'm afraid he's a few years too late.
Years?
I have more important business to attend to. Besides, he can handle anything alone. He assured me so himself. What could he possibly need my help with?
We're up against vampires. A dear friend of mine was just recently killed. I've lost so many friends to vampires, and I can't stand by anymore and let another soul die without me getting involved in this. Now we need your help.
Vampires? That might change things. Tell me more about what's going on.
We're not sure, but they have an Elder Scroll.
By the Eight. All right, look. I'll consider it. But I can't just leave this bear to prey on more innocent people. Once it's dealt with, then perhaps I'll see what Isran expects of me.
Here, I'll take care of the bear for you.
Where'd you come from?
They're satisfied. Oh wait, there's more.
Where'd you come from?
Any more bears? This poor archer. Dead. All right, we're done here.
Don't know how well I'd have managed by myself. You have my thanks. You've helped me, so I suppose the least I can do is find out what Isran wants. He's still at that fort near Stendar's Beacon, I assume.
Yes, he said to meet him at Fort Dawnguard.
Of course he did. He's been working on that place for years now. Never lets anyone in. His own little fortress. Well, I guess I'll get to see what he's been up to all this time. I'll meet you there.
Very well.
I'll see you at Fort Dawnguard.
Yes. Wait, this is new. I was wondering if we were going to experience any more vampire attacks, but I guess not. Hail! Isran certainly was busy while I was gone. Tildy, is it?
Need something?
I'm just checking in, see how things are going.
Isran knows how to fight those monsters. He's been preparing for this day for a long time.
Very well. Not as attractive as I thought you were from a distance.
Now that the Dawn Guard are back, the Vampire's reign of terror is about to end. Yeah?
I have to agree with you. Especially since I'm here. Right, well it looks like security is under control.
Got us all here. Now what do you want?
Really?
Hold it right there!
What are you doing?
Isn't this a
Making
bit dramatic?
Sure you're not vampires. Can't be too careful. So welcome to Fort Dawnguard. I'm sure you've heard a bit of what we're up against. Powerful vampires, unlike anything we've seen before. And they have an Elder Scroll. If anyone is going to stand in their way, it's going to be us.
is all well and good, but do we actually know anything about what they're doing? What do we do now?
We'll get to that. For now, get acquainted with the space. Sorin, you'll find room to start your tinkering on that crossbow design you've been working on. Gunmar, there's an area large enough for you to pen up some trolls. Get them armored up and ready for use. In the meantime, we're going to get to the bottom of why a vampire showed up here looking for you. Let's go have a little chat with it, shall we?
Hope you're getting along with Isran. It takes some getting used to.
You think? And how am I supposed to get up there? I know nothing at all about this castle. Oh, this place needs a lot of work. Dogs. Hello. How are you? What's wrong? You want to hunt some vampires? Sorry, maybe next time. Ah, here we are. Gotta find some lightweight boots. These heavy boots make too much noise. What's this? Lusty Argonian Maid? Another copy? A very popular book. There's more crossbows. That wasn't the right staircase. Here's another one. Hopefully this will get me to Isran. Yes.
So let's hear it.
You.
You probably weren't expecting to see me again.
No, I wasn't. What are you doing here?
I'd rather not be here either, but I needed to talk to you. It's important, so please just listen before your friend here loses his patience. It's... well, it's about me and the Elder Scroll that was buried with me.
The one that you keep carrying around on your back? What about it?
The reason I had it, and why I was down there. It all comes back to my father. I'm guessing you figured this part out already, but my father's not exactly a good person, even by vampire standards.
Okay.
He wasn't always like that, though. There was... a turn. He stumbled onto this obscure prophecy and just kind of lost himself in it.
What sort of prophecy?
It's pointless and vague, like all prophecies. The part he latched onto said that vampires would no longer need to fear the sun. That's what he's after. He wants to control the sun. Have vampires control the world. Anyway, my mother and I didn't feel like inviting a war with all of Tamriel, so we tried to stop him. That's why I was sealed away with the scroll.
What does all this have to do with the Dawn Guard?
I'm sorry. I had heard there were vampire hunters here. I thought they might want to know about a vampire plot to enslave the rest of the world. Was I wrong?
Sarcastic, but you do have a point. You are right. We just have to convince the others that you're on our side.
Well, let's move then. I'm nothing if not persuasive.
Oh, you heard?
All right, you've heard what it has to say. Now tell me, is there any reason I shouldn't kill this blood-sucking fiend right now?
Because... And I'm hesitating here because I kind of agree with you that we probably should kill her. But it seems that we might need her help.
Why? Because of that story about the prophecy, about some vampire trying to put the sun out? Do you actually believe any of that?
Why else would she risk her life to come here?
Who knows? Maybe it has a death wish. Maybe it's just insane. I don't really care. It can stay for now. But if it so much as lays a finger on anyone here, I'll hold you responsible. Got it. You hear me? Don't feel like a guest, because you're not. You're a resource. You're an asset. In the meantime, don't make me regret my sudden outburst of tolerance and generosity. Because if you do, your friend here is going to pay for it.
Thank you for your kindness. I'll remember it the next time I'm feeling hungry. So, in case you didn't notice the giant thing on my back, I have the Elder Scroll with me.
Yes, how could we not notice?
It will have something that can help us stop my father. But, of course, neither of us can read it.
Who can?
Well, the Moth Priests are the only ones I've heard of who can do it. They spend years preparing before they start reading, though. Not that it helps us anyway, because they're all half a continent away. In Cyrodiil.
Some Imperial scholar arrived in Skyrim a few days ago. I was staking out the road when I saw him pass by. Maybe that's your Moth Priest.
Do you know where he's staying now?
No, and I'm not going to waste men looking. We're fighting a war against your kind, and I intend to win it. You want to find him? Try talking to anyone who'd meet a traveler. Innkeepers and carriage drivers in the big cities, maybe. But you're on your own.
Any idea how you're going to find a Moth Priest? Skyrim's a pretty big place.
How
Any idea
I'm
how you're going,
going
to find,
a, moth
find a
Moth Priest?
Skyrim's a pretty big place.
Where would a Moth Priest actually go?
Well, back before I... You know, the College of Winterhold was the first place I'd think to go for any kind of magic or historical thing.
Of course.
The wizards know about all kinds of things that people probably shouldn't know about. Actually, now that I think of it, I'm going to come along with you.
Are you now?
I've been really wanting to get out and explore a bit.
What do you know about Elder Scrolls?
I mean, as much as anyone. Not a lot. You'd figure a couple hundred years locked away with one would have given me some insight, but no. Turns out you don't learn much from just sleeping with something.
That's probably truer than you possibly know. I guess we'll have to keep looking for that Moth Priest then.
I guess so.
Were you always a vampire?
That's a long story.
I want to hear it.
I guess we kind of have to go way back, to the very beginning. Do you know where vampirism came from?
I don't know much about it. Only that good friends of mine have died because of people like you.
The first vampire came from Molag Bal. She was not a willing subject, but she was still the first. Molag Bal is a powerful Daedric lord.
I've met him.
And his will is made reality. For those willing to subjugate themselves, he will still bestow the gift, but they must be powerful in their own right before earning his trust.
How did you actually become a vampire, then?
The ceremony was... degrading. Let's not revisit that. But we all took part in it. Not really wholesome family activity, but I guess it's something you do when you give yourselves to a Daedric Lord.
How has it affected your family?
Well, you've met most of us. My father's not exactly the most stable, and eventually he drove my mother crazy with him. And it all ended with me being locked underground for who knows how long. It's definitely been a bad thing, on the whole.
Do you ever think about curing yourself?
A cure? Why even think of it that way? I can't think of any reason I'd want to lose this gift, especially after what I did to get it. It may have driven my family apart, but I'm still here, and I'm alive. I won't give this up.
I knew it would come to this one day. I knew, and no one believed. Be on your guard at all times. Avoid sleep if you can. Sleep is for the weak.
That explains the bags under your eyes, then. All right, Serana.
Even with all my preparations, we can't be too careful. The monsters could strike us at any moment.
You talk about paranoid. I have got to get rid of these boots. I'm not used to making so much noise when I walk. Good. Okay. Next time, we seek out the Moth Priest.